Rose from happyandauthentic.com. Today I'm going to talk about shopping more mindfully. When first starting out with minimalism, a lot of people struggle with the temptation of buying new things. They feel like they're not allowed to buy anything new ever again. And the situation that ensues is a lot like crash dieting. They restrict themselves so much that in the end they can't take it anymore and they end up binging. The trick to avoid binge eating is to follow a balanced, healthy diet as a lifestyle. And it's the same with minimalism. It needs to become instilled in your daily life as a healthy routine. Not a strict rule that you're never allowed to break just because, but as a logical, reasonable way of life that you understand and want to follow for your own reasons. So tip number one is to ask yourself why you want to be a minimalist. Think about it in terms of what you're gaining, not so much in terms of what you're giving up. That way it'll be a much more pleasant experience overall. Are you trying to be a minimalist because all your friends or celebrities you look up to are doing it? Or is it something inside the core of your being that is telling you you're going to gain things from it that you yearn to experience? If you really want something in an authentic, essential way, then you'll be better equipped to handle the hard times that will inevitably come with it. Tip number two, adopt a one-in, one-out policy. If what you already own are things you absolutely love, and you know that making a new purchase means you're gonna have to get rid of one of those things, you will think long and hard before you buy anything new, because you won't be as eager to get rid of the things you're already attached to. Number three, keep a shopping journal. Now, this doesn't have to be a specific notebook that you handwrite everything into every time you buy it. Just figure out a way that you're comfortable recording everything you purchase and how much it cost. If you follow a budget, you probably already do this, so it won't be anything new. If you don't, then it'll be a very positive habit to start, because it'll also save you money. Of course, for the purposes of this video, the point is not to save money, but to help you be more minimalist in an easier way. When you write down your purchases, it helps you track your shopping habits, and to see if any particular life circumstances tend to trigger unplanned expenses. Maybe you tend to buy more clothes after a hard day at work. Or maybe you treat yourself to a brand new tool set every time you get a promotion. Either way, if you're ending up with more things than you're comfortable with, tracking it will help you figure out the underlying issue that you need to tackle. Number four, wait at least a week before purchasing something new that caught your eye. I know it sounds like a really long time, especially if the item is on sale. But remember that that's the whole point of sales, to make you rush into buying something you normally wouldn't think about. So when you see something that you feel compelled to purchase, give yourself a week to think about whether or not it's actually necessary. Make a point of actually thinking about the item for at least 5 minutes a day for 7 days. Consider whether or not you have similar items already, or if it matches the things you already own. If you consider everything and you still find yourself wanting to purchase it at the end of the week, it likely means that it's something that will enhance your life. So go for it. Number five, ask yourself if this new item will match at least 3 things you already own. Now, this isn't just for clothes and shoes. It could apply to things like furniture, decorations, or any number of things, really. If it doesn't match any existing items, it likely means you'll either be inclined to buy more things that match it, or to get rid of it because it sticks out like a sore thumb. Either way, don't deviate from your existing color palette, unless you're okay with things not going together. Six, make a list. The dreaded L word, I know. Of course, having a list is absolutely pointless if you don't stick to it. So it's not only important never to go shopping without one, but also to make sure you don't deviate from the list. Having a list reminds you that you're in the store with a particular purpose in mind. The items on the list are, hopefully, things that you've already taken the time to consider whether or not you need them, want them, whether they match your already existing belongings, and that they won't clutter up the house. If it's not on the list, it means you have not yet given that item the prerequisite consideration that it needs. And number seven, don't go shopping just because you're bored or emotional. Shopping therapy isn't therapeutic for long. All it does is skirt the issue. Your problems will still be there when you return. You'll just have bought something you don't really need and spent money that you otherwise could have saved to spend on something that actually is important to you. Make a personal rule not to go to the mall as a treat or a day out. Don't go window shopping, and only go to particular stores when you have a pre-considered reason. So there you go, my 7 tips to shop more mindfully and minimally. If this video taught you something, or if you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. and subscribe so you don't miss next week's video about minimalist budgeting tips to help you save money. See you when I see you.